Hello, good morning students. Today we discuss about the control statements in Java. Okay, generally control in Java, like other programming languages such as C or C++, this power is accomplished with the help of different kinds of control statements. Okay, basically the power of programming language lies in their ability to instruct a computer to perform the same basic operation again and again on repeatedly till a specific condition is satisfied. Okay, so basically control statements allow us to change the sequence of instruction for execution. Okay, execution. Basically control statements are of the following types. Basically it will be categorized into the three: selection, iteration and jump. Okay, so basically selection, iteration and jump. So first of all we discuss about the selection statements. Basically selection statements are also known as decision making statement. That means ki by using this statement we can take any concrete decision. Okay, basically the selection statement will be also categorized into the two parts: selection statement and switch statement. In the selection statements, there are different types of statements that will be used. First is the if else, okay, nested if or else if ladder. Okay, these are the different types of statements that are used in the selection statements. Okay, first of all we discuss a simple if statement. Okay, basically if statement is generally used for the condition having the single output, that is the condition is the true. That means ki if a statement will be execute in which case when the condition becomes true. Here we can see that the structure of or syntax of the if statement is if condition statement. Here condition will be specified by using any relational operator. Okay, and if the condition becomes true, this statement one will be executed. Okay, here we can see that the curly braces is a pair of curly braces is here. Basically this when the if statement followed by a single statement, then there will be no requirement of the pair of curly braces. But in case of the multiple statement, we must require the curly braces. Okay, in the practical session we can see what is the effect on the output. Okay, basically when if condition having the more than one statement, like a statement one, a statement two, a statement three, then it does not generate any error during the compilation of the program, but it will be effect on the output of that program. Okay, so basically the simple if statement is be it will be evaluated if the value of the condition is the true. Okay, that means generally it is used not in the practical or real implementation, because in the real implementation or in real application we have to display in both of the condition if the condition becomes true or if condition becomes false. Okay, basically here we show a flow chart. Okay, that means ki what is the data flow. As we know that when we develop any program, so we have to follow a programming development life cycle, that is PDLC. P for programming, D for development, L for life, or C for cycle. Okay, so this is the programming development life cycle. And in programming development life cycle, first we have to prepare an algorithm. Algorithm is what? It is a sequence of steps that we use to perform any specific tasks. Okay, so first we have to prepare algorithm, then we have to prepare the flowchart. Flowchart is what? Flowchart is simply a pictorial representation of your algorithm. Okay, by flowchart here we can use some symbols, and this flowchart represents the working of the if statement. Here start, here the condition will be specified. If the condition becomes true, a statement will be executed, and if the condition becomes false, there will be no any statement. That means there will be no any message for the user when condition becomes false. Okay, here we can say that simply If marks greater than or equal to 36, system dot out println you are passed. That means ki if any students having the marks that is greater than or equal to 36, okay, then it will be passed. But in real life, we have to also display a message regarding the failure. Okay, so in the beginning of the session, I told you that if a statement is not generally implemented in the real time applications. Okay. Now we discuss about the second conditional statement, that is the if else. We can say that if else is the extended form of the if statement. Okay, as we know that if statement only considered the only considered when the condition becomes true. That means ki the message will be displayed in the case, in only one case, when the condition becomes true. But in real life, we have to display in the both conditions. Okay. That means if the condition becomes true, a statement will be displayed, a proper message will be displayed for the user or customer, okay? And if the condition becomes false, then also a message will be displayed what will be the error, okay? So to implement such type of events, we can use the if else statement. Here we can see the syntax of if else. Here if condition, okay, if the condition become true, this statement, okay, this is known as the true block. Also we can write here true block. Why it is known as the true block? Because this block of code will be executed when the condition becomes true, okay, but when the condition becomes false, this else part will be executed, okay? So we can say that it is a false block and it will be executed when the condition becomes false. So basically it is the real life implementation where the condition may be true or where the condition becomes false. In such situations, we can use if else statement. Okay, basically in this syntax, here we can say that the true block consists only a single statement, and false block also consists of single statement, that is the statement 2. But in case of a true multiple statement, it may be if the condition becomes true, multiple statement will be executed, statement 1 up to statement n. Okay, in such situation the curly braces must be required. Okay, but in case of the single statement, okay, if the case of the single statement, there is no any requirement of the curly braces, it may be given or it may be not. It does not affect on the compilation or execution of the program. But when the true block consists multiple statements, that means the more than one line of code, then it must be enclosed between the curly braces. Okay. Otherwise, it generates some logical error during the execution of the program. Now we can see what is the data flow of the if else statement. First the condition true, then a statement 1 will be executed, then end. If the condition false, that means a statement. We can see what is the similarity between the dissimilarity between if else flowchart and if flowchart. In the if flowchart, this statement 2 will be not there, okay? But in case of if else statement, statement 1 and statement 2 will be there. We can see this is the simple, there is no any statement here. But in case of the if else, here is the both of the statements is here. Okay, here we can send it. If marks greater than 36, system.out println you are passed, else system.out of println you are failed. This is the real approach that has been generally used to develop any type of software. Okay. Now here we see that if else if ladder, okay, what is the else if ladder? We can see if condition statements, okay, then else if condition, fir else if. Basically this is used for the multiple conditions will be executed at a time. Okay, if condition statement else if, that means ki this condition will be exist, okay, this statement will be else if, that means otherwise this condition will be evaluated, then otherwise this condition will be added, and lastly this is the statement. Okay, basically this if else if ladder will be generally used for to evaluate multiple conditions at a time. Okay, basically this situation will be generally occurred when we have to find out the maximum value of the given three elements, four elements. Okay, we have to find out the different grades of the students. Okay, here we can send it. Suppose here we can see the example of the simply we have to find out the what is the day. Okay, suppose if day equal to 0, Sunday. Else if day equal to 1, that is Monday. Else if day equal to 2, Tuesday. Else if day 3, that means key up to day 5, okay, Friday. Else system dot out println Saturday. Okay, so this is the basically the use of the else if statement. Here we can check more than one conditions at a time. Okay, basically a nested if statement. We can also use the nested if statement also. Basically a nested if is an if statement that is target of another if or else. Nested ifs are very common in the programming. Okay, already we discussed basically such type of condition will be generally used for the validation also, and it will be also used for the finding the greatest among the numbers. Okay, so basically this is the statements. Okay, first we have to discuss if statement, second if else. Okay, next we will see else if statement, and last in the nested if statement. Now we discuss about the practical approach of such type of decision making statements. Okay, now we go for the edit. Okay, first of all we see a simple if statement. Class, suppose we name the name of the class is a class decision. Okay, public static void main. Now string s. Okay, first we have to check the if statement. Okay, suppose int a equal to 5, b equal to 6. Okay, here we use if a greater than b. Okay, we write system dot out dot println. Okay, output will be plus 8. This is the simple if statement. Okay, as we know that simple if statement consists only a true block. Okay, generally I have already said in case of the single statement that is associated with the if, there will be no any requirement of the curly braces. Okay, now we save the program by the name of the decision dot java. Okay, save. Now we have to compile java c decision dot java. Now run decision. Okay, what is the output? There is the no output. Okay, here we can see that edit decision dot java. Basically here a equal to 5 and b equal to 6, so a equal to 5, so 5 greater than 6, the condition is false, so there will be no output. Okay, but this is the wrong approach. Okay, we have to also use if the condition becomes false, we have to also display the message. So basically this is the limitation of the if statement. Okay, what is the limitation? It only works when the condition becomes true. Okay, now here we can see that if the a less than b. Now the condition becomes true and it will be display the value of a. Okay, now we check. Okay, here the value is the 5. Okay, now we can see what will be the effect when the if condition will be this if statement is associated by the multiple statements. Okay, suppose here we can write system dot out dot println. Simply we are display an statement hello. Okay, suppose what will be the condition if the condition becomes true. Okay, as we know that a 5 less than 6, here the condition becomes true. What will be the output? Here we can see okay, that means here we can see that both of the statement will be executed. Okay, now we can check what will be the effect when the condition becomes false. That means more than one statement, if here the if statement will be associated with more than two statement, and if the condition becomes true, then both of the statement will be the executed. Okay, both of the statement will be executed when the condition becomes true. Now we have to see what will be the effect when the condition becomes false. Okay, here as you know that this condition will be become false. Now we can see what will be the effect. You see, that means key the first statement is skipped and the second statement will be executed. Okay, so basically we have to see such type of approach that will be generally used in the programming language. Okay, that means here we can see, here we can write when the condition becomes false, it escapes the first statement. Okay, this is the actually approach. Okay, but now we discuss about the, I hope you understand simple if statement, and we can also see what is the effect when we use the multiple statement without the curly braces. But when use the curly braces, okay, then what will be the effect? Now in these conditions, when we use the curly braces for the more than multiple statements, okay, for more than one statement that is associated by the if statement. Now here the condition becomes false. In this situation, there will be no output. Why? Because here we use the pair of curly braces and or the multiple statement are enclosed in the curly braces. Okay, and the condition becomes false, there will be no output. But when the condition becomes true, both of the statement will be executed at a time. Okay, now we see what will be the effect of if else statement. Okay, new class season 1. Okay, public static void main string s. Okay, now we can see what is the if else statement. Okay, suppose int e equal to suppose int marks equal to 60. Okay, here we check if marks greater than or equal to 45. Okay, then what will be the result? We can see system pass otherwise we can say system dot out dot print ln fail. Okay, so this is the if else statement. That means we here is an scope of the when the condition becomes true, okay, and when the condition becomes false. Okay, so basically this is the reliable, okay, in comparison to the if statement. Now we can see file save. Okay, this will be named as the decision one dot java. Okay, now we go for the compilation. Yes, Java C decision one dot here, yeah, Java C decision one dot Java. Okay, now we execute decision one. Okay, this is the pass. Okay, so here we can see that it will be work in the both conditions. Okay, when the condition becomes true or when the condition becomes false. Okay, now we can see what will the effect when the one multiple statement has been given. System dot out dot println. Suppose here we can use a simple statement. Hello. As we know that the here the condition is a true condition is true. Now we can see that what will be happen if the multiple statement in the true block and there is no here we have no any declaration of the curly braces. We already discussed about that if the if any statement, okay, that means ki this if statement associated by the multiple statements, okay, then curly braces will be required, but in case of the single statement there is no curly braces will be required. Okay, so now we can see what will be the effect if we use no any pair of the curly braces in case of the multiple statement. Okay, now we compile. Yes, that you can see that system that is with an error. Okay, that is the else without if. Okay, so basically this is the type of the error. Here we can see again if that means key it requires us a statement. Okay, now here with the if curly braces, yeah. Okay, now we see file save and file exit. Okay, Java decision one. Here we can say that now the error will be removed. Okay, so when we use multiple statement, okay, in the case of if else and we do not use the curly braces, it will generates an error. Okay, so what will be the error? Okay, we can also display on the screen. So basically, in case of the multiple statement, okay, we have to use curly braces. Okay, that means the curly braces must be required in the case of multiple statements. Okay, otherwise it will generate an error. Okay, so basically this is the use of the if else statement, and we can easily see that what is the effect when we do not use the curly braces in case of the multiple statements. Okay, now we see else if statement. Okay, we can see that is the nested if statement. Okay, what is the nested if statement? Basically, if under if condition, okay, then if condition, okay, basically this is the we can use the multiple statements at a time. Okay, that means when a series of decisions are involved, so we may have to use more than one if else statement. The if statement may itself contain another if statement is known as the nested if statement. Okay, now we can see what are the different types of programs that will be generally used. Okay, basically when we use the nested if statement, okay, it provides a more complexity in our program. Okay, basically this type of statements that is generally used to find out the greatest among three numbers, four numbers, five numbers. Okay, this is I will continue the nested if statement and else if statement and switch statement, switch case, in the next. Okay, because all of the three are related to each other. Okay, now we conclude the session, and I hope you better understand the use of the simple decision making statement like if else and else if statements. Okay, thank you.